Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of the Venom Vlog. And today, we're going to start something that I've been wanting to do for a while. Obviously, there's some old Eddie Brock storylines that we never got around to. We did like a big jump in time to get to the Matt Gargan stuff and try to wrap some of that up. And I always promised that we would go back to like the early 90s and we would tackle some of the early Venom appearances, not just in his own miniseries, but then in other people's books as well. And that's what we're going to do today because I figured this would be fun. It's kind of like a Venom versus series in a way, and they won't be every episode consecutively from here forward, but we'll just, bounce around and do some of them in between now and like, the month of May and stuff. And now that we're coming up on Venom's 31st birthday, and I was like, yeah, this is a cool way to go back and look at some of his early stories, see some of his early appearances, and kind of see other writers that don't normally write the character kind of tackle him, who didn't write him on a consistent basis. And I thought this would be fun. So I wanted to start since also we're coming up to Marvel's Endgame, and I'm redoing all of, rewatching all those movies because on my channel I haven't really reviewed the MCU movies, really, maybe like four or five of them. And so someone came up with the idea like, oh, why don't you rewatch all of them and then, give like, 5, 10 minute reviews. And so I just recently rewatched Iron Man, and I was thinking, that'd be a good spot to start with Venom, because right after I think Carnage first appeared and I started to learn about the character of Venom, I decided to go back and find other books of his and that we you know where he was and like appearances he made. And around this time is when I discovered this book, Iron Man, issue 302. And Iron Man was already a book I had been reading because around issue 288, I think, War Machine had taken over, and that was the first Iron Man book I had ever picked up as a kid. So I always thought War Machine was Iron Man, actually, but I read those books consecutively, and I was kind of enjoying them, but I think some of it was going a little bit over my head. Len Kaminski was writing it at the time, and I was, I think he was writing it closer to 300 or maybe a little bit before. But then, I was kind of enjoying the book, but when Tony Stark came back, I was kind of like, oh, I liked War Machine, and I kind of thought War Machine was Iron Man, so I started to disconnect from the book a little bit. Not that I don't like Tony Stark, but it was my introduction, and my introduction was Rhodey, and it was kind of like with Green Lantern. My introduction to Green Lantern was during a storyline called Mosaic with John Stewart as Green Lantern, and then when Hal Jordan came back and Guy Gardner, I was like, who are these guys? Like, who's? I thought John Stewart was Green Lantern, so it was a kind of a fun time for comics for me because of my entry point. I thought, the characters were totally different characters, and then they switched pretty quickly. So when Tony Stark came back in, he was going through like this virus thingy. He couldn't always even walk at times. So he had like this floating chair, like Professor X style. And he had this little thing, this visor he wore on the top of his head, and he could control things like life model decoys and the Iron Man suit and stuff. So he wasn't always active in duty. He wasn't physically fit to to fight or defend himself. And that's kind of why Rhodey, kind of took over for a while, because Tony was going through all this crazy stuff. He was running his company. He was doing some questionable things, I guess, depending on which side of the fence you're on politically, because they even make a note in this book, issue 302. It's called Crash and Burn, and Venom shows up at the end of 301 because he claims that Tony Stark's current actions with his company are going to put innocent people at risk. And in this book, it's kind of funny because Nell, who is the editor at the time of this book, he comes in and says, this is like when Venom grabs Tony and he says, you're putting innocents at risk. We're here to kill you. It says like in the captions, Venom is referring to something Tony Stark's doing with his company, but this is a very liberal interpretation of like of what Tony's actually doing. And it was kind of funny because I remember reading that as a kid and being like, Mom, what's liberal mean? And she had to like kind of explain it to me and stuff, because obviously Tony deals with military contracts and things like that, and Venom's coming in like with this different point of view. He grew up in San Francisco, has a different approach to things, and kind of has a liberal outlook on things, although he is very intense and violent with his symbiote. But his goal in his mind is to protect innocence. So that's how he always translates things, is that he thinks he's the protector of the innocents, the lethal protector, right? So he shows up at Tony Stark's doorstep, ready to take him down. And Tony Stark, when he gets grabbed, he's kind of like, oh crap. And Venom bites into his neck and pulls his head right off, like page 3 of this book. And I'm like, oh, whoa, what the heck? Like I just learned who Tony Stark was. And I was going, eh, like, because I remember reading it going like, Rhodey, come in and help him. But Rhodey didn't show up in this issue. It was just Venom versus Iron Man. And Venom bites into Tony Stark's neck and rips his head off. And you find out that it was actually a life model decoy, that Tony Stark has felt weak after current battles, you know, because he gets in the Iron Man suit to basically stay mobile, stay healthy in a way. It's kind of like his new addiction when he's in this chair. Like, he gets in the suit and it's kind of like his new addiction and his way to get out of the chair. So he's not in the suit yet. He's downstairs, you know, in his floating chair, and he's hearing all this going on, and he sent a life model decoy upstairs to like check on something, and Venom shows up and bites its head off. So Venom's like not happy that it's not the real Tony Stark. So he starts trashing his way through Tony Stark's tower to find Tony. And when he does, he says, like, you know, he's like, hey man, you can hide, but you can't run from me. Now that I'm here, I'm going to take you out. So Tony jumps, like rolls off his chair and jettisons his chair at Venom, shooting him through a wall. So it connects with Venom and they go out a wall together. And so, you know, Tony's like, all right, that's only going to buy me a few seconds, basically. And then this guy's going to come back in and he's going to tear me apart. He's going to rip my head off, just like he did the life model decoy. So Tony is actually crawling. You know, it's a very intense storyline, I feel, in my opinion. It was like, when I was watching this, I was like, holy crap, this guy's gonna die. Like, Venom is gonna straight up kill this guy. And so Tony Stark's crawling, you know, to the ground. He's crawling to get to the secret elevator. And meanwhile, Venom's like coming back in. He's like, all right, you know, you got me with that one, but that's not gonna take me out for good. I'm coming to kill you now. And then as he's chasing down, Tony Stark, Tony crawls in the elevator and the door shut immediately, and it's taking him down to the Iron Man armory. And at this point, you know, Venom doesn't really know Tony Stark is Iron Man. He just knows that Tony Stark, you know, is doing this, you know, thing with his company. So Venom is not prepared to fight for Iron Man, or he wasn't ready for it at least. So as he's like looking for Tony still, Tony shows back up in the Iron Man suit, and the two of them now really go at it. And Tony's basically like, all right, the kid gloves are off, I'm taking this guy down. And the two of them start fighting. And when Venom like shoots his web at Tony and it covers like the Iron Man face and Tony can't see, he decides to switch to ultrasonic. So it's sending out these ultrasonic waves around him, almost like Daredevil style, where the sound is creating an image for him, almost like an infrared-y type image for him to see so that he can continue the battle. And the ultrasonic sounds start really irritating Venom and the symbiote. And Venom gets really, you know, angry about it. He's just like, shut him off, we hate them. And then he jumps on Tony, starts clawing at him, but the sonics keep going and going. And then Tony, you know, starts punching him back. They get into this big battle. And then as Venom leans in to bite him again, you know, bite into the armor, Tony Stark reaches up, or Iron Man reaches up, grabs Venom's tongue and sends an electrical jolt through him, electrocuting Venom and shooting him back into a wall. And that's when Iron Man stands up triumphant over him. And he's like, all right, man, round 3, like, you know, you came in, you took, you know, fought Tony Stark, now you're fighting me, and then now I got the upper hand, so here we go, I'm going to put you down for good. And then Venom's like, no, I'm here to protect innocence, I'm not the monster here, Tony Stark is. And then Iron Man says, all right, you think you're here to protect innocence? Prove it. Prove to me that you're here to protect innocence. You know, give Tony Stark the time he needs to fully realize his plan, and you'll see that he's actually not putting innocent people in harm's way. He's trying to come up with a solution for something. And Venom kind of looks at him, you know, and he's like, I don't know if I trust you. And he's like, I'm Iron Man, I'm a hero here, you know. And he's like, well, you do protect innocence. And he's like, so give me the chance, give Tony the chance. And if he fails, we'll both bring him in together, you know, kind of thing. And then so, you know, Eddie's like, fine. He's like, all right, you know what? I'll give him a chance to prove it. But if he doesn't, I'm going to come back here. And not only am I going to eat Tony Stark, but I'm going to eat through that metal suit and chew you out as well. And then Venom disappears. And so after that, Tony Stark is like, holy crap, like, I barely got out of that alive. You know, and he's like sitting in his chair, and he's like, you know, his butler and all these people come in, you know, and they're like, what happened? He's just like, you know, I don't want to deal with it. He has like a nurse at the time. He's like, I don't want to talk about it. You know, basically we just got attacked, but you know, the intruder's gone. And you know, I really got to think about this plan and what we're doing. And at the same time, as he's like, you know, saying that, that's when Captain America actually shows up at the end of the book and is like, Tony, we need to talk. And so it's even Cap is like, you know, coming and knocking on his door. So, you know, it's a brief battle. Venom showed up at the end of issue 301, and they pretty much fight through all of this issue, which is 302. You can find this issue issue on Comixology. I don't think they've reprinted it in any, maybe one of the Venom omnibuses, maybe. But other than that, no trade paperbacks, as far as I know, have this issue in it. But it's really good. I liked it. I think John Hopgood did the art on it, if I'm not mistaken. That time era is kind of a blur to me. But a lot of great people were working on it. Len Kaminski, like I said, he was writer of Iron Man at the time. But he also wrote a couple of the Venom miniseries that we talked about as well. So, but this was his first, I think, kind of time writing Venom, and I thought he did a really good job. It kind of captured who Venom is, and saying the stuff that Venom normally says, but while having fun with it, and then having him fight Iron Man, which was really cool, and the visuals were great. So, and I had some of them pop up on screen here, so hopefully, you guys, enjoyed that as well. I don't want to give away the whole book, but I want to give away a couple pages that looked really great. Hopefully, get you guys to go buy it. Check out Iron Man issue 302 on Comixology if you want to read the full story. So that's it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Like I said, I'm going to do more of these. I think there's like Dark Hawk and Nova and other people that, Venom showed up in their series to fight them for like an issue or two, Silver Sable. And then there was also like the Marvel Comics Presents story where Venom and Wolverine first meet. And they fight up against a guy named Nightmare or something from Doctor Strange. So we're going to talk about that as well in an upcoming episode. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks so much. Let me know down in the comments below what you thought of this battle. If you've read the comic, let me know your favorite moment, and we'll continue the conversation down there. Thanks so much for watching my show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you in the future. Peace.